In this illustration, we'll discuss about a ball rolling on a sphere. Here we are given that the figure shows a ball of radius r rolls without slipping down from the top of a sphere of radius r from rest, and we are required to find the angular velocity of ball at the moment it breaks off the sphere. Here in the solution, we can write if at an angle theta from the initial position the ball breaks off, we can again draw the figure for analysis and better clarity. And this was the initial position of ball. And from the initial position, if it reaches an angle theta, then here at this position, the ball will be experiencing its weight mg. And in outward direction, it will be experiencing a normal reaction plus the centrifugal force, which is mv square by r plus capital R. If the ball is moving at a speed v at this position, then here we can write if at an angle theta, ball breaks off, we use, in this situation, we can write at this point as n becomes 0, then we can write mg cos theta, which is acting in inward direction, this theta. So in this direction, the force is mg cos theta acting on it, and this plus, this must be equals to the normal reaction, which is 0 as it is breaking off, plus mv square by r plus r. Here we are taking n is equals to 0 at the point of breaking off. So in this situation here, m gets cancelled out, and we'll get a relation that g cos theta is equals to v square by r plus capital R. And by work energy theorem, we can write this from a starting point to this point. We can write that initial kinetic energy of ball was 0 plus from this point to this point, work done by gravity on ball is mg r plus small r 1 minus cos theta is equals to final kinetic energy of the ball, which we can write as half mv square plus the rotational energy in the ball, which is half moment of inertia is 2 by 5 mr square multiplied by, for pure rolling we can write its omega as v by r whole square. Now if we simplify this, it gives us g, here m already gets cancelled out in the equation, and this gives g multiplied by r plus small r 1 minus cos theta is equals to, on simplifying, you can see this 1 by 2 v square plus this 1 by 5 v square, as this 2 also gets cancelled out and this r gets cancelled out. So in this situation, this 1 by 2 plus 1 by 5 is 7 by 10 v square. And further, if we simplify this value of cos theta, we can write from here as v square by r plus r. So this gives g times r plus r minus g times r plus r cos theta, we can write as v square is equals to 7 by 10 v square, which gives us the value of v is equals to root of 10 times g r plus small r divided by 17. And as we have got the value of v, we are required to find the angular velocity of ball at the moment it breaks off. So the value of omega we can write as v by small r. So this will be given as root of 10 g r plus small r divided by 17 r square. That is the result of this problem.